Hello everyone and welcome to this video lecture. In our today's lecture, we will see features and limitations of HTTP protocol. So first of all, we will see the features of HTTP protocol. So let's see it one by one. The first feature of HTTP protocol is, it is a communication protocol and it is used to make the communication between web browser and web server. So now let's understand this topic very well. So suppose this is our web browser, but suppose this is our client PC and this is our server PC. Okay, now if we want to check how this web browser or client communicate with the server, okay, so to make communication between web browser and server, we have to use one concept, and that concept is HTTP protocol. Okay, so we can simply say that HTTP protocol takes parts between the communication of web browser and web server, and that's why it is also called communication protocol. Now let's talk about the second features of HTTP protocol. The second features of this protocol is, this protocol is based on the request and response messaging. Okay, to enable the communication or to make the communication between web browser and web server, HTTP protocol uses the request message and response message. Okay, and that's why it is based on the request response messaging. Okay, suppose this web browser want to open or want to display any web pages that is available or that is stored on the server, then web browser will send the request message to the web server with the help of HTTP. After getting the request from the web browser, web server will process that request. At the end of that process, whatever the output we get, web server will send these responses back to the web browser as a response message. Okay, so in the communication between web browser and web server, HTTP uses the request and response messages, and that's why it is based on the request response messaging. So this is the second features of HTTP protocol. Now the third features of HTTP protocol is, it is a stateless protocol. Now what is the meaning of this stateless protocol? So we have two different words. First word is stateless and second word is stateful. So let's understand the meaning of stateless protocol, or why HTTP is called stateless protocol. So HTTP is called stateless protocol because HTTP protocol cannot remember previous user's information. Now what is the meaning of this? Suppose our browser have opened three websites. So to open these three websites, browser have sent three different requests. Okay. So our HTTP protocol does not store all these three requests. It simply sends the request to the server. So after sending request, it forgets or it erases all the data from the request message. Okay. So if we ask HTTP protocol, please give me the information about last request, then HTTP cannot provide this information to us because it cannot store or it is storing any previous information. So with the help of HTTP protocol, we cannot get any previous user information. So this is the reason why it is called stateless protocol. Okay. Now the second thing is, it does not remember the number of time the user has visited particular website. Suppose I have visited a particular website 5 times. I want to keep the track of all these things, then with the help of HTTP it is not possible, because HTTP simply forward our request to the server and after that its work is done. Okay, it does not store our requests or what are the data that we have sent in our request. Okay, so with the help of HTTP protocol, we cannot find any previous user's information, or nor it store any user's information like how many times did this user have a particular website. And this, because of this reason, HTTP is called stateless protocol. Okay. Now the last feature of HTTP protocol is, HTTP protocol has cache control mechanism. Now, if we want to know how many websites we have visited during last 1 hour, then with the help of HTTP protocol, we cannot get all this detail. But if we ask the same question to the browser, or if we want to know how many websites we have visited during last 1 hour, then we can see all the websites that we have visited in the browser's history. Okay, so whatever websites we have opened or whatever the resources we have served, all these things are stored in the browser's cache memory. Okay, so HTTP protocol have cache control, but it does not store information. Actually, browser store all this information. Okay, so this cache control is the advanced feature of HTTP protocol. Okay, so most of the web browser automatically store the recently visited web page. Okay, so here we have to make one thing clear. All the web browser automatically store recently visited web page. Okay, so make sure web browser stores all this information automatically. But HTTP protocol does not store any information, and this is the reason why it is called stateless protocol. Okay, so these all are the features of HTTP protocol. Now let's see the limitations of HTTP protocol. Okay, so there are three different types of limitations that HTTP protocol have. The first limitation of HTTP protocol is HTTP protocol is not a secure one. Okay, so whenever we want to send any sensitive information, okay, we cannot use HTTP protocol. So if we want to send any sensitive information, for that we can use HTTPS, because HTTP is a secure protocol, but only HTTP is not secure protocol. Second limitation is it is a stateless protocol. Now we have also seen this HTTP is a stateless protocol as a feature, but in some case it may be limitation. Why it is limitation of HTTP? Because if we want to remember the previous communication, or if we want to keep the track of all these things, then with the help of HTTP it is not possible, and that's the reason HTTP is stateless protocol is the limitation of HTTP protocol. Now the third limitation is HTTP is a text-based protocol. Means whatever information we are sending in the request message or response message, all this information are in the plain text format. Means the communication is purely in the readable format. Okay, so anybody can read this information. Okay, so if we send the sensitive information with the help of HTTP, then any third person or any third party can see this information, and they can steal or they can breach our information easily. So the text-based protocol, HTTP is a text-based protocol, and this is the limitation of this HTTP. So HTTP has a three limitation. First limitation is HTTP protocol is not secure. Second limitation is it is a stateless protocol, and third limitation is it is a text-based protocol. Okay, so this is the limitation of HTTP protocol. Now let's talk about examination perspective. So in examination, examiner can ask, explain or justify it. HTTP is called as a stateless protocol. Okay, so we can give the answer as HTTP is a stateless protocol because HTTP does not remember the previous communication, or it does not remember how many times a particular user have visited particular website, and this is the reason it is called as a stateless protocol. Thank you.